Number 12. Amy Kirsch. In June of 2020, Colorado woman Amy Kirsch suffered a fatal accident while on a guided rafting trip down the San Juan River. The 43-year-old woman was thrown from the raft on a white water section of the river north of Pagosa Springs. Her husband and three teenage children could only watch in horror as she was swept downstream for several miles. Even though she was wearing a life jacket, a helmet, and protective headgear, Kirsch was swiftly overwhelmed by the raging waters. A guide in a separate boat caught up with the woman on an island in the river and started CPR. Kirsch was then rushed to a hospital where she was later pronounced dead. Number 11, Maria Noakes. On March the 3rd of 2018, professional kayaker Maria Noakes drowned while paddling down the Chioa River in North Carolina. The woman, a New Zealand whitewater champion, was accompanied at the time by her two teenage sons. Noakes had been paddling the river for over a decade, and it wasn't considered a challenge for her. She had previously competed in races in which she shot over Class 5 or expert level waterfalls. Those who knew the 50-year-old kayaker were shocked by the incident, which some have described as a fatal fluke. It happened below a rapid portion of the river known as Python. The exact circumstances of the accident aren't known, but Noakes' boat was found pinned against a bank while her body was recovered downstream. In the wake of her demise, hundreds of condolence messages ranging from New Zealand to Kathmandu filled her social media. Number 10, Costa Rica bachelor party accident. In October of 2018, a group of friends celebrating a bachelor party in Costa Rica was involved in a brutal whitewater rafting accident. Wind and rain had initially delayed the trip, but the guides eventually gave it the green light. 14 men were grouped into three rafts alongside five guides and went down the Naranjo River. Within minutes, the relentless currents caused the rafts to capsize. Most of the men stranded in the turbulent waters managed to grab onto rocks or barriers in the river. The remaining five, including the groom's brother, as well as a local guide, were unable to fight the currents and were carried downstream. They were lost to the river, and it took rescuers over 5 hours to recover their lifeless bodies. An investigation was launched into the incident to determine what responsibility rested with the guides for pursuing the trip in spite of dangerous conditions. Number 9. Lauren Seitz. Ohio teenager Lauren Seitz succumbed to primary amoebic meningoencephalitis in 2016 as a consequence of a whitewater rafting experience in North Carolina. In June, the 18-year-old was part of a church group that embarked on the trip at the U.S. National Whitewater Center in Charlotte. An investigation revealed that Seitz only went underwater when her raft overturned. In doing so, she contracted a brain-eating amoeba that's naturally present in the water. Called Naegleria fowleri, it enters the human body through the nose and travels to the brain, causing a severe infection. The Center for Disease Control only reports about 10 cases per year, but the outcome is typically fatal. The center claimed that it got its water from a system that was treated with chlorine and ultraviolet radiation, meant to render the amoeba inactive. Yet Seitz died just over a week after her church group returned from the trip, with the CDC suspecting Naegleria fowleri as the cause of her passing. Number 8. Joshua Perrocchi. Australian man Joshua Perrocchi died in a whitewater rafting incident on the Shotover River near Queenstown in May of 2018. Perrocchi, a New South Wales policeman, was on a raft with six other tourists and a guide. Powerful currents overturned their boat and they fell into the violent waters. Perrocchi was being pulled to safety from a section which was called the toilet due to its swirling currents. The 31-year-old then lost his grip and was swallowed by the oncoming rapid. A safety kayaker aided him in navigating to shore, but shortly after reaching land, Perrocchi became unresponsive. He was treated by a paramedic. In spite of CPR and the use of a defibrillator, the man didn't recover. The survivors were airlifted to a local hospital where they were examined and offered counseling. Number 7. Unnamed British soldier. In June of 2012, an unnamed British soldier lost his life while whitewater rafting in Austria. The 22-year-old was with a logistics support regiment based in Germany. The trip was offered to him and other servicemen as an adventurous training activity. He and seven others arrived at Landeck in Western Austria and were in the third raft to go down the river. Shortly after they set off, a massive wave overturned their raft. As the servicemen tried to turn it upright, the victim lost his grip on the boat and was swept downstream, where his body was later found. In the incident's aftermath, doubts were cast on whether the rafting experience should have even taken place, considering the torrential rains that the region had experienced leading up to it. Number 6. Samantha Morton. Shortly after finishing a degree on adventure tourism, Samantha Morton headed for Thailand to experience whitewater rafting. She arrived in the Mae Tiang district in August of 2006. Shortly after embarking on the trip, violent rapids flipped her raft and the 23-year-old, along with other tourists, ended up in the water. As the currents carried her away, a local man tried to save her by throwing a rope in the water. Morton held onto the rope at first, but it then wrapped around her leg and pulled her underwater. The local man who'd rushed to her aid was ultimately forced to let go as he was being dragged towards the rapids. Morton's life was claimed by the river and her remains were recovered downstream. Number 5. Michael Either. In 2017, Brisbane electrician Michael Either left Australia to embark on the trip of a lifetime. He visited Canada and the United States before reaching South America. About a week after Either and a group of friends had traveled through Antigua, the 23-year-old went rafting in Guatemala. On January the 23rd, he was accompanied by a Portuguese companion as they rafted the fast-flowing rapids of Rio Cajaba. At one point during the trip, their raft capsized after it was struck by powerful waves. As they went over a big drop, the two men became separated in the water. Either's companion was found the following day wandering through the jungle. Either, however, was never seen again. After the Guatemalan authorities concluded their search, Either's family set up a GoFundMe campaign to pay for further exploration into harsher terrain. It was ultimately concluded that even if the young man had survived the initial drop, he would have swiftly succumbed to swim failure. His final resting place is believed to be an underwater cave, which, due to the strength of the currents, is physically impossible to reach. Number 4. Matthew Hitchman. In August of 2017, Matthew Hitchman, his classmates and his teachers were on a month-long trek through the Andes. The 17-year-old UK student and the other members of the trip were taking part in a community project to provide sustainable income tourism to one of Ecuador's remote areas. One portion of the experience involved whitewater rafting. During the downriver trip, Hitchman was thrown from the raft as it approached some aggressive rapids and got caught in rocks. A number of his fellow rafters jumped in the river and tried to rescue him. While undoubtedly heroic, their efforts ultimately proved futile. Hitchman's foot had gotten caught in rocks that prevented him from resurfacing and he drowned. Hitchman's grief-stricken parents subsequently expressed their gratitude towards the teens who'd foregone their own safety to try and save their son's life. Number 3. Amanda Taylor. Days after she'd been missing, Amanda Taylor's lifeless body was found on a bank of the Arkansas River. Taylor hadn't been seen since her dinghy overturned while she was whitewater rafting on the river. The woman and six others were left to fend for themselves in the turbulent waters of the Arkansas. Five made it to shore and another man was subsequently rescued as he was still clinging to the raft. Since they'd gone out at night, the lack of visibility further complicated the fight against the powerful currents. Survivors remember the dread they experienced as they were being pulled underwater, as if inside a washing machine in pitch black darkness. Fortunately, they were all wearing life vests. Taylor was the only one still unaccounted for as the rafters regrouped. Her family came in from Wyoming to help with the search efforts. After 4 days, it was Taylor's brother that found her body. A coroner's report stated drowning as the cause of death. Today's topic was requested by Kanadi, Daniele, and Alicia Trevathan. If you have any other topics you'd like to learn about, subscribe and let us know in the comments section below. Number 2. Michael Arena. While chaperoning his son's Boy Scout trip, 52-year-old Michael Arena lost his life on Dead River in Maine. Arena was one of two chaperones overseeing the group of teenagers. They were on a commercial rafting trip when they ended up in the water. The others managed to scramble their way to safety, but Arena was overpowered by the currents. An ambulance crew pulled him from the water and he was pronounced dead at the scene. Official They Will Kill You merchandise is now available at theywillkillyou.com. Some of it is to die for. Number 1. James Abromaitis. James Abromaitis died in June of 2016 after he was thrown from a raft during a whitewater trip down Roaring Fork River in Aspen, Colorado. The Maryland man and his wife had chosen Aspen Whitewater as the operator for their rafting experience. The trip was marked by trouble from its first minutes. Abramitis was ejected from the raft, but recovered after he was pulled inside. The second time the man was thrown off, he couldn't be resuscitated and died on the spot. Abramitis' widow subsequently sued the operator for misleading them about a leg of the river called Slaughterhouse. They'd apparently downplayed the risks involved and marketed it as suitable for beginners. Additionally, heavy spring runoff had swollen Aspen's rivers and Slaughterhouse ran at over 2,000 cubic feet per second. This made it even more dangerous than under normal conditions. The lawsuit ended in an undisclosed settlement. Thanks for watching. Would you rather go rafting on a Class 5 rapid or try to drive across the Sahara without a map? Let us know in the comments section below.